Hello everyone, I'm Tim from Tim Does Level Design and welcome to the final episode of my beginner course in video game level design. If you've made it this far, I think there's quite a lot you can be proud of already. Let's have a short recap of everything you've accomplished so far. You've learned some of the basics of using Unreal Engine and how you can use it to create your own simple blockout levels. You have learned about gym levels, their role in video game development, and defined crucial metrics for your own project. You've learned how different enemy types can be used to create a variety of different experiences in synergy with your 3Cs and different level setups. You've experimented with various level design ingredients, also known as interactive props, level elements, entities, or gameplay objects. You got your hands on some basic design documents and used all these fundamentals to plan and block out your own first level. You've applied various blockout techniques and use different design methods, making your content better through various iterations. You also got a brief taste of level art and used some play sessions to gather valuable feedback. All in all, we touched on the most important elements of what you need to design your own video game levels. And with what you've learned, you should now be able to finish up your blockout of your own Q6 level. And if you have the dedication to do so, create some completely new additional levels from scratch. But when you've completed this course and finished creating and polishing your own levels, what should you do next? It will depend a little bit on your situation. Perhaps you're a student interested in video game development and are looking to apply to a college or university with a game development degree. Maybe you're already in college and are hoping to get an internship at a video game company or want to apply for a junior level design position. Maybe you're already in the industry or are a hobbyist that just enjoys practicing their level design skills and would like to learn more. Regardless of the position you're in, the most important thing you can do to become a better level designer is to build levels and keep building levels. You can use this platform and project to create more levels and polish them to whichever degree you would like. But to continue making new and different stuff, it's good to know that existing video games occasionally have their own level editors as well. In the good old 90s and early 2000s, it was quite commonplace for many games to ship with their own editors. The original Doom, released in 1993, still has an active modding and level design community, and there are multiple map editors publicly available. Valve's Hammer Editor is a very well-known tool and allows you to create your own maps for games like Half-Life 2, CS:GO, or many of their other games. So I do recommend searching the web for existing level editors, picking one that tickles your fancy, and just start following some of the many available tutorials and continue building your own levels. Even though it's not as common practice anymore for games to ship with their own level editors, it's always worth keeping an eye on upcoming releases. I do expect, for example, Team Fortress 3 to have an active modding and map making community in Source Engine 2 when it finally releases. Titan Quest used to have a fairly robust editor as well, so I'll be keeping my eye on the eventual release of a game like Titan Quest 2 to see if any editor or modding support will arrive over time as well. Also, for the past few years, Epic Games has been pushing an initiative called Unreal Editor for Fortnite, which is a specific version of Unreal Engine made specifically for creating games and experiences directly into the Fortnite ecosystem. This might provide an easier entry to level design than the full Unreal Engine, as it has a lot of pre-existing gameplay functionality to get started with. But of course, it's also possible to simply continue your journey of learning Unreal Engine 5, with its vast amount of features. The main downside is that it doesn't, by default, come with a ready-to-go game that you can build your own levels for. You could look into the free game samples, existing free or paid game templates on the marketplace, search the web for people kind enough to share their game project files, or dive into more extensive free or paid tutorials to create your own game prototypes. And remember that Unreal Engine isn't the only game engine, and alternatives are available. Whichever path you choose here, just make sure to continue building levels, as that is the main way to get better at it. But in addition to the practical aspect of building levels, there's a lot of theory and soft skills out there too. I tried to do my part by occasionally covering a topic on my YouTube channel, but other content creators are available. On YouTube, you would be wise to follow creators like Steve Lee, or Max Pears with their podcast Level Design Lobby. as well as search for other level and game design channels out there. I've created the Ultimate Level Design playlist with a ton of interesting videos and channels for you to check out. If you find some interesting content out there for me to add to the playlist, please let me know in the comments down below or join the Tim Das Level Design Discord server. If there are video game conferences and events in your area, they're usually a great place to learn something, but more importantly, to network with people in the industry. Some conferences will regularly post some of their presentations online, and noteworthy is the GDC Vault, with some content available for free, though a lot of it is locked behind an expensive paywall. If you're not opposed to spending a bit of money on your learning journey, there are a number of level design books on the market as well. The couple that I'm displaying here are some that I read and at least got some value out of, though more books are available and I haven't read them all yet. In short, the internet is full of answers and information. You just have to put in the effort to search for what you need. So keep building levels and stay hungry to learn more. But whether you're looking to apply for a college or an industry job, you're going to need a portfolio website. This is where you showcase the best of your level design abilities to convince recruiters and fellow developers that you're qualified for the position. When applying for a school, versatility is important to showcase that you have put in your hours and are ready to learn more. Though when applying for a game studio, you're often judged by the lowest quality piece in your portfolio, so it's best to be selective with what you display, making sure it showcases the best of your abilities. And it can't hurt to cater to a specific genre or niche of games when you know where you'll be applying to show that you're the best fit possible with the type of games that these studios are creating. When you're looking to apply to a college or university with a game design related degree, it can't hurt to be selective. Over the past years, many schools have started offering some form of game development degrees, simply because they know there are more and more people interested in the field. Though worldwide, there are definitely more game design students than there are jobs available in the industry, and the available degrees in this topic vary a huge amount in quality. Do your research well to determine which schools are worth your time, and a good standard of measurement is to see if the school employs teachers with actual game industry experience. And last but not least, at the time of recording, we're nearing closer and closer to the month of October, which over a number of years in the level design community has become known as Blocktober, which is a celebration and recognition of level design blockouts, where many developers, big and small, share screenshots and videos of their current and past blockouts, mostly on Twitter, under the hashtag Blocktober. It would be fantastic to see some of you participate in this, and if you happen to be sharing any blockouts based on this course, feel free to tag me at TimDasLevelDesign or share them with me and others on the TimDasLevelDesign Discord. It has been a crazy amount of work creating this tutorial series, and I truly hope it will benefit some of you out there. The game industry can seem big, but can be surprisingly smaller than you think at times. I hope I come across some of you sooner or later at a game studio or during one of the many game industry events. Best of luck, and hopefully I'll see you in my next videos.